हरि ओम। विष्णुर् गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरवे नमः गुरवे नमः। हरि ओम्। वेलकम फॉर दिस प्रीनेटल क्लास लेक्चर The science of birth. Very important point is this. Everybody must think about this topic. But nobody is thinking. That is the tragedy. Yoga science and Ayurveda science, they explained the secret of birth. And that is very important point related to this prenatal class. You people are here to learn something related to the science of birth, and which point I will explain you, that is very important point. Whenever I used to think about this point, I feel that this is the base of whole human life, and the rights are given to the mother and father, parents who are going to give birth to a very great child. Every mother and father, they want their child should be the greatest personality in the world. They want it. And they can get it. That type of science is developed through this yoga and Ayurveda, both the sciences. They are explaining this point in detail. What is the detail level, or what is the base of this thought that everybody must give birth to a child which will be the greatest personality in the world? And that is, we have to think this point. We are thinking about the child only from the body point of view. We must think the body should be healthy, no doubt about it. Think about the healthy child concerning with body. Think about the child, strong mind child. Think about the child, very brilliant and clever child. Think about the soul also. We are not thinking about the soul. That is the point here. We are thinking about the body of the child, mind of the child, little bit, intelligence of the child, little bit. But we must think, we have to include this soul point in this. What is this science? The Indian philosophy explains us there are countless souls roaming around us. Countless souls are there. Which soul should take birth? That is the point here. And that is the science. So my main point here to talk to you, that which type of child you want, you can give birth that type of child. That is your right. But you have to learn this technique. This is the technique only. So, how they explain this technique? Another thing, we are thinking about our child, which type of child we will give birth. We are thinking about this, his body, his mind, his intelligence. But what type of work he should do, that child should do, we are not thinking about that. So let us give birth to that type of child, which will be the greatest child thinking about all the different matters about this human life, about this community, about the nation. So all these points should be included before the birth of child, before having conception. The very important point is this, but nobody is thinking about it. When you feel that you are pregnant, then we are going to the doctor. But before that, it is given in Ayurveda and yoga science how you should think. Mother and father now ready to give birth to the child, they must think about all these things. They learn these things. They should learn it. I did very nice social work. I am very happy with that, my social work. What I did? People are inviting us for the marriage ceremony. So I have printed 1,000 letters that, and I was giving them as a present in the envelope to that new couple. And I was asking them, before going to honeymoon, you should come to me and talk to me. I will explain you what is this birth science. And I talked to so many couples with my this letter. Around about 1,000 letters I have circulated in the community, not more than that. And I talk this science to so many couples. Now here, I want to explain you that same thing, how you will give birth to a brightest and very clever child and efficient child or brilliant child. So that is my point here. Just now I told you, countless souls are around us. They are roaming here and there. Don't get afraid of this, my statement. This soul, when they will come before you, it takes long time. It takes long time. No problem in that. Don't worry. But all the souls, they are traveling according to their own journey. They are following their own journey. Nobody knows. We also don't know which soul is inside our body. What is the journey of our soul? We don't know. And yoga science is meant for that. We must know the journey of our soul, which is working in our body. So we don't know about our soul, so we don't know about others' souls also. So don't get afraid. They are around us. Every day new flowers are taking birth. So how these flowers are taking birth? They all are hidden in this environment. And today one flower has taken birth, then it will finish its work tomorrow, and tomorrow new soul of that flower will take birth. Some flowers are very good. If we concern with one tree, some flowers of that tree, they are very good, but some are not good. So this is the science. Why they are not good? Because of they did not get very nice nourishment for them. All flowers, all the offshoots of that tree, they got it. But one offshoot, that flower was not good. So we have to think about this thing which is happening around us. So what is this soul science? Now I am explaining you the science of soul. I am not going in details. I am explaining you small points concerning with this science of birth. So which type of soul is taking place or getting birth from you? That is the science. And this first right is given to the lady or the mother or woman. She is the first responsible person to give birth to any type of child. She should be a wise lady. She should think everything positively. Then she can give birth to a very nice child. So first, base of any child's birth is dependent on the mother's body health, mind health, and her intelligence or her thinking level. So she should learn everything. So first rights are given to the mother. What type of child she should give birth? If she is blank, she is negative, she is not thinking about that, then the father is responsible. Father is the second responsible person to give birth to any child. First, mother should think, and what type of her thinking, that type of soul will take birth in her womb. That is very important. So mother she should learn everything before giving birth to any type of child. Then if she is not active, father is responsible. Child will be the nature of father. So this base you have to keep in your mind. Then another point I am explaining you now. What is this birth science? Very important point now I am explaining here. The woman, or the lady, she is giving birth to one seed every month. How many ovums are taking birth from a woman? One for 1 month. For every month, woman is giving, or she is creating, one ovum. And if you calculate all the ovums, how many ovum she is giving birth? 70,000 ovums in her whole life. She can give birth to 70,000 ovums. And what is the capacity of one man? He is giving, or he can give how many sperms are entering from him in the woman's uterus. At one time, 1 teaspoon full sperms are entering in that 1 teaspoon man is entering in that mother's womb. How many sperms are there? 20 million sperms are there in 1 teaspoon. So this is very important thing. One ovum, opposite side, 20 million sperms are standing in that uterus. 20 million sperms are ready to concept with that ovum. So which sperm is attracted? Now here we have to think. This is very important point. The ovum of that woman, what is the impression on that? That type of sperm is attracted to that ovum. Suppose this ovum is not good, or it is full with negativity, full with bad qualities, then that type of sperm is attracted. If the ovum is full with bright impressions, positive impressions or some ideologies before that woman, that type of sperm will be attracted among that 20 million sperms. So this is the science we have to keep in our mind. So how this woman or the mother or the lady, how she is impressed, how her behavior, according to that, sperms are attracted towards that ovum. Now I will give you some examples. This is the basic science. If everybody knows this, then whole community, there will be total change. No bad humanity or human beings, they will take birth. Everybody will be the very good human being. So this way, we have to think about it. Now I will give you some examples from the historical background of this thing. I will explain you. In history, Indian history, I know, you must be knowing the name of Lord Hanuman. Hanuman, how he took birth? His mother was, and his father also, they went for the meditation. That mother, her name was Anjani. She was basically very good nature. She was having very good nature. And she purposefully got married with that Kesari. He was the king of that empire. And both they got married. And both of them, they decided that lady, Anjani, her name was Anjani. She told her husband, I want to give birth to a very strong and brilliant child. I want to give birth for that. Both of them decided, and they went for meditation and practicing yoga, and they were busy with their all this meditation state, yoga practicing for 1 year. And after that, they gave birth to Hanuman. Very strong and very intelligent and brilliant. Though he was monkey, but he was very clever. And he surrendered himself for the whole community. His work was not allotted to himself, no selfishness. He surrendered himself to the total community. That was Hanuman. And after that, he started working only for the good work, that is Lord Rama's work. And he helped him a lot. And all his strongness and everything, he used it for Ram. Hanuman never did any bad thing in his life, never. He was very good in his nature right from his birth. So this is the secret behind this Hanuman's birth. Another example, you might have been heard the name of Lord Shivaji from Maharashtra. Shivaji, he was very successful king in Maharashtra. Why he got so much success? Because of his mother only. His mother decided that I will give birth to such a nice king. I don't want ordinary child. I want king should take birth. So she tried for that. She impressed her everything with this thought. And her husband was also running behind this thought only. He was thinking that I must give birth to such a strong type of king. So Shahaji was the name of Shivaji's father. And Jizabai is the name of Shivaji's mother. And she was having, both were having first five children. And Shivaji was the sixth number child. First five children, they were not so active. And this Shivaji, he was the king. How this happened? Just now I told you, for every moment, Jizabai was thinking about the king, about the king only, nothing else. So she got success in that. Another example I will give you, the story of Lord Krishna's time, that Mahabharata story. One king was there and he was having two queens. He died before giving birth to any child. So these two queens, they were not having any child or any prince for their kinghead, empire. So they wanted it. That's why they were thinking. But king was not there. So another arrangement, another son of that their mother-in-law's another son was there. So she called her elder son to give birth to the child in this empire. She called that, his name was Vyasa, Rishi Vyasa. And he was looking little bit ugly, means not ugly, but he was ugly for these queens. They were thinking a very brilliant or very nice prince, he will come there and then they may have conception. Both the queens, they were thinking like that. But this Rishi Vyasa, he came. The first queen, her name was Ambika. That Vyasa Rishi came in her room, and she, because of fear, she closed her eyes. And after that, she gave birth to a blind child. That was Dhritarashtra, the name of that king. After some time, he was the king of that empire, Dhritarashtra. He was blind because of mother's this impression on her ovum. She closed her eyes. Then another second queen was there. Her name was Ambalika. When that Vyasa Rishi came near to her, her mother-in-law, she told her, don't close your eyes. That first Ambika closed her eyes and something was wrong. So you don't close your eyes. She made her alert. She never closed her eyes, but she got frightened and she lost her whole energy. Her whole strongness was gone. So she gave birth to a weak child, Pandu, King Pandu. He was very weak. So, and third birth at that same time, that Vyasa Rishi came to his mother and he told his mother that Ambika closed her eyes, so her child will be the blind child. So I want to go to her again. You tell her about me. She can come to me. I will change this, what happened with her. I can change it. You send her to me again. But that Ambika never listened. And she sent her working lady with her to that Vyasa Rishi. And that working lady, she was working with Ambika. She was the servant there. And she, Ambika sent her servant to that Vyasa Rishi. That servant, that lady was blank. So she gave birth. What type of nature of that child was? He was very clever. His name was Vidur. First blind child was Dhritarashtra. Weak child was Pandu. And strong and brilliant child was Vidur. He was the son of that servant, lady servant. So, that time, when that Vyas Rishi go to that servant lady, that time she was blank, and Vyas Rishi was his, the sperm of his impression, clever sperm of his impression, it took birth. So this way, how you make your impression strong, how you are impressed with which thought is very, very strong in your mind, that type of child takes place or birth. So all these stories you can keep in your mind. You are teaching to, you will teach as a prenatal teacher, you will teach to some pregnant ladies. So how you will change their mind? Just now I explained you the ways of this birth science. If you think about this, you have to prepare to give birth to a child very nicely. So long time you have to make preparation for that. Otherwise you make your mind strong and give birth to a child. Suppose now late 2-3 months pregnant ladies, they may come to you. From that time they will come to you up 6 months or 7 months. So conception is there. Just know what I have told you, that is over. The conception is there. Now they are taking care of their child, which is up till now, which is 2 months or 3 months in the womb. So they are taking care of that. Then if you want that child should become good child or the very brilliant or whatever qualities you want, you start chanting Om for that, with that purpose. If you do that, what is the power of this Om? Om is very strong mantra. How it will be effective with this type of pregnant ladies? Keep a good thought in your mind. Just now I told you, what type of child you want? You want very strong child like that, or mind should be very nice, or whatever it is, good qualities if you want. You keep all these qualities in your mind and ask that pregnant lady to chant Om with this thought, which she want. Om is so capable science. Om can change the impressions on the soul from the last birth. That much strong Om is. If you ask that child to listen that Om, specifically put your palms on your belly or uterus point and chant Om, the child's previous impressions, bad impressions, will vanish. Om impress your otherwise the impressions of Om chanting is in good form only. Om creates holy energy. Om never creates bad energy. So chant Om and change the impressions on the soul which is taking birth from your womb. The previous impressions will be, they will be finished with the Om chanting. Why I am explaining this point here? Suppose the conception is done there. Now, no question of just now, which science I explained you, that point was finished. Then who will help you in this matter? Om is the greatest science. It's a special science, big science. Countless books are there related to Om in all the languages in India. So many type of changes will be there because of the Om, and you can give birth to a strong child. Which type of child you want, that type of child will take birth. So this is the science of this birth. Another thing, nowadays how we are thinking about this child of birth, we are thinking only the body point of view. Body should be strong, my child should be a healthy child. This is correct, no doubt about it. You have to think, and you have to develop your child like according to that. Then what is our another point? My child should be have very good nature. Mind should be very nice. No negativity there. No, means strong mind. If you think like that, you keep this thing in your mind. Then we are thinking, my child should be very brilliant, very clever. This is also okay. But think about the soul of the child also. And for the soul purpose, you try to practice this yoga science, asanas, whatever, which things you are learning, and you are going to teach other ladies. So yoga science is the very important science which is helpful to fulfill your all desires. What are your desires? I have explained you in detail. So but the important point in this yoga science is you have to think about the soul reformation of this child, and that is done by yoga asanas, pranayam, which you are learning, which is suitable for that pregnant lady. Then you try to chant this Om and try to learn meditation also, Om meditation and other things. So this is the whole thing, all the things related to the this birth science. One more thing I will explain you and then I will stop. That last point is, if you have given birth to the child, everything is finished, then the child is not in you now, he is out. So still, ask that child to learn yoga science and chant Om. About the other mantras, I will talk to you in my next lecture. So this is enough. So you can chant Om, then everything will be positively, and you can fulfill your all desires with the help of Om chanting. So Hari Om. We will meet again.